dependent on agriculture, directly or indirectly. We are busy in agriculture. And it is a burning topic also these days. For the students going to the CSAT and mains examination this year, agriculture of India is very important. There will be definitely about 50 marks from agriculture. And in agriculture, it is not a simple unit. They will not ask you what are the salient features of Indian agriculture, what are the characteristics of Indian agriculture. Such things will not be asked. The questions may be on the agricultural productivity, crop combination regions with different formula, different techniques, agricultural intensity. So those areas are to be thoroughly covered, and that is technical area. So apart from industries of India. Industries of India also give. That is a very simple unit that generally give 25 to 30 marks. Next one is the transport, trade and commerce in India. Sometime a question is asked, sometime the question is not. I will cover all these topics, all these units. These are the first 5 units, the part 1 of paper 2. In the second part, we have the cultural setting of India, ethnicity of the Indian race, growth and distribution of Indian population, density of population, agricultural density of population, sex ratio, literacy rate, dependency ratio, religious composition. Then there are some topics like occupational structure, migration. Migration is common to the first paper as well as to the second paper. So from this unit, always plus cultural regions of India, regions demarcated of India on the basis of language region. This is also important. So one full question about 50 marks. The total weightage of this unit is 50, and no paper setter ignored this unit. So identify physical setting of India, agriculture of India, then the cultural setting of India. These are most important. After that comes the settlement geography. In the settlement geography of India, we have in the rural settlements, morphology of rural settlements, types and patterns of rural settlements. These are the components. In the urban geography, we have one common topic, functional classification of towns. That is in the first paper as well as in the second paper. Morphology of Indian cities. In the world perspective, we cover in the first paper. What is the morphology of Indian cities? This is a specific example that will be covered in the second paper. Then, how the Indian cities can be made sustainable, where they can sustain. Plus, what is conurbation? And the new concept given by Geddes that will be discussed. Geddes' concept of conurbation. And conurbation means when more than two million cities merge with each other, that is known as a conurbation. So the study of conurbation and problems of Indian urbanization. The next unit in your course is the regional planning in India. Cover several topics. Very easy unit, and each year a question is not asked. It depends if the paper setter is involved from JNU. There may be one question from regional planning. If the expert is from some other university, there may be less weightage on this unit. Then political issues of India. Political issues of India, the course given is geographical basis of Indian federalism. Why India has a federal constitution? What are the geographical reasons for that? Then boundary disputes with the neighboring countries. This is also a topic in your political issues of India. Then geopolitics of the Indian Ocean. Very important area. Generally a question is asked on the geopolitics of Indian Ocean. Then India's role in the world affairs. It is a very small unit, but changes in the land use pattern of India. such current issues, floods and droughts, then epidemics, plus sustainable development, environmental impact assessment. It is also a small unit, and very generally some short notes are asked from that unit. So this is your course. Plus, there will be one compulsory question on map entries. So map entries also deserves, because it is a numerical type of question. If it carries 25 marks, the student may secure 24 marks. Some may get even 25 out of 25. So this is the deciding question in the second paper. Because some students secure 20 plus out of 25. Others may be getting only 5 marks. So the difference of 10-15 marks cannot be covered in the descriptive paper. Earlier it used to be 60 marks question. Then it became a 50 marks question. Last year they reduced it to the weightage of only 25 marks. Because the students were securing very high marks in this question. Only those who have the regular practice. So this is the course content of the second paper. Those who joined or came here for the first time, let me tell that we are going to start the second paper. When the second paper is over, we will go back to the first paper. We don't want to put anybody in darkness, but the whole course will be covered systematically, unit by unit. I will be starting the physical setting of India tomorrow. That is it. But today, since there are some new students, I am covering a very important topic, and the topic is important from the examination point of view. That is, green revolution in India. Or socio-ecological implications. New agricultural strategy of India. Green revolution is a grain revolution. The question may be in any form, the answer will be the same.